Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Wake Up Missoula. I'm your host, Scott Ramph. I have lots of things to talk about today. I got some news. I got some weather. I have a little bit from a parade that happened in Missoula last Saturday for the International Wildlife Film Festival. I got some more MCAT news for y'all. I got some Megs featuring Ryan Feddersen, who will be ending her run at the Missoula Art Museum by the end of this week. So we have a nice little talk that we filmed with her. I'll show you a little bit of that with other new programs that will be on MCAT later in the show. I got some City Council. Well, they'll be talking about Pride Week, Religious Freedom Week, and all sorts of other proclamations that are going to be in effect this week here in Missoula. I also have the Stop Animation of the Week. I got some events for you guys to keep you busy within the next 2 days. But let's kick off with a little bit of weather. It is currently 34 degrees outside. It's going to be a sunny day out there. You have a high of 58 degrees. Your low is going to be 39 degrees. This morning, it was a little frosty on my window, but it wasn't a big deal. Your Thursday, however, is going to be a high of 55, low of 38, not much change, but there's going to be rain. There's going to be a 30 to 80% chance of rain. It'll be a little more predictable later on Thursday night and Friday. Friday and Saturday, you can expect your, it could be partly cloudy and be sunny by Saturday, but I'll check in with you guys also to see what the weather's going to be like on Friday. So let's talk about some of the news. The University of Montana, to help get out the vote, has created the Friend Vote. It's an online database to see who voted and who didn't. This is kind of crazy, since no one should have the right to tell you to vote. And I've met some folks in town who push voting on people like they have nothing better to do with their lives. I'm going to sound biased now. Well, of course, I already did just sound biased then. But this kind of thing is an invasion of privacy. Yes, you are in the public record when you register to vote, but you shouldn't have others knowing the knowledge of how much you vote or how little you vote. You got to remain on the issues on hand and try to be as unbiased and fair, because by showing any kind of sway one way or another, you're just another cog in the political machine, basically. So vote, don't vote, it's your right, but don't let people know how much you voted or how much you didn't vote. It kind of makes you look like a tool. So I got that story, I got basically that information. Most of it's my own opinion, but I got it from the Missoulian, and I thought that was kind of crazy, personally. This next one is from the Billings Gazette. In Helena, the Montana Senate has endorsed a bill that would require Northwestern Energy to absorb some of the financial burdens that result from unexpected outages instead of passing all those costs onto its customers. The unexpected action on Tuesday comes just days after the chamber narrowly rejected an attempt by Republican Representative Jedediah Hinkle of Belgrade to have the matter heard on the Senate floor. Regulators were pushing the measure after Northwestern Energy challenged the Public Service Commission Commission's order requiring the utility to refund Montana taxpayers $8.2 million. Hinkle said that this motion to resurrect the matter was a last-minute decision made just an hour before Tuesday's vote. In national news, former Microsoft CEO Steve Ballmer launched a new tool designed to make government spending and revenue more accessible to the average citizen. Their website is called usafacts.org. The site prominently features an infographic created to break down the revenue and spending in 2014. Revenue is broken down by origin. Spending is broken down by what mission of government it serves based on the functions laid out in the Constitution. Ballmer's wife pushed him to do this since he's been retired as CEO of Microsoft, and since then he's been working on this kind of like watchdog tax revenue for citizens. For many people, the government has a tendency to make tens of thousands of pages devoted to budget and government spending like a huge long receipt. But Ballmer wanted to use this data and make an algorithm and try to figure out a way to narrow down areas of spending that may or may not be legitimate to persons' views. The site says it is factual and unbiased and doesn't make judgments or prescribe specific policies. Ballmer, for his part, said he wanted the project to be completely apolitical and has given money to candidates on both sides of the aisle, the Times reports. But data never exists in a vacuum, as Wired says, infographics are inherently editorialized. Still, the site avoids taking positions on any kind of policy, but you do understand that when this kind of thing is put into place in 2014, it talks about the government in the Obama era. So in a ways, I can kind of be put editorialized towards one way over another. So this is a new kind of like website which allows people to kind of see what the government is spending on through graphs and pie charts and stuff. So you guys can look that up on usafacts.org. I got another news thing that happened over the weekend. If you guys got a chance to be out and about, even if it was kind of unseasonably cold on a Saturday, during the Wild Walk Parade, MCAT live streamed it. It's on our website, on our Facebook page, and you can access it at any time. But I'm going to show you a little taste of what you guys missed. And when I come back, I'm going to talk a little bit more about MCAT news and all and our upcoming party. Yes, as you can see, it was the 25th annual Wild Walk Parade to highlight the 40th anniversary of the International Wildlife Film Festival. And you can see all the people who all kind of bunched up celebrating everything animals. And it's just a nice and wonderful event that happened here in Missoula that happens annually. Usually the Saturday basically kicks off the International Wildlife Film Festival. And the films are still going on this week, and I'll talk a little bit more about what films are going to be playing this week at the Roxy, so you guys can check it out. So let's talk about some MCAT news. So if you are interested in being a part of MCAT, we host orientation every second Wednesday of the month. Last Wednesday was our last orientation, so you're going to have to wait about probably about 3 or 4 more weeks until the next one. So here is the website. You go to MCAT.org to find out more information about Missoula Community Access Television. If you have any problems, you can contact us by calling us at 542-6228. You can email us MCAT@MCAT.org. This is our, and then our address up above is 500 North Higgins, Suite 105. Just follow the icon on the location on the bottom left-hand corner. Summer camps are almost coming and are almost here, and if you have any kids age 9 to 13 and 14 and above, you guys are more than welcome to sign up for our summer camps. Spots are filling up like crazy, so we do a lot of afternoon day camps, but we have one big camp which highlights the zombie camp that is going to be happening on here. So you click on the link right here, and you get your options between each of the summer camps, and you can register online by clicking on that icon right there. But let's go back to MCAT.org. You guys can win a cruiser bike, a courtesy of Freecycles. Freecycles built this bike especially for us, so we could raffle it off on our May 5th anniversary party. So let's skip this real quick. So on May 5th, enjoy complimentary appetizers, a drink on us, and conversations with friends. The party is at the Downtown Dance Collective Friday, May 5th from 5 to 8 p.m. during First Friday Gallery Walk Week. So you guys can totally check that out. It's going to be great. We'll wrap it off then. We're also doing Saturday drop-ins, Saturday animation drop-ins. It's a day drop-in from 1 to 5 p.m. every single Saturday up until May 20th. When we'll have our last weekend, we'll be showing off all the stop animations the kids have done in the 2016-2017 season. We start in the fall after Labor Day, and then we come back, and then we stop In Memorial Day, and of course we stop during the holiday weekends and stuff like that. I think the only times we really stop is during Thanksgiving weekend, and then the two weekends in Christmas holiday and New Year's holiday as well. So just those weekends, but every Saturday we do our Saturday drop-in animation every Saturday from 1 to 5 p.m. It costs $10 per drop-in, and if you have a kid and they don't want to do like a half day, they can do 2 hours for $5, and we're pretty good about it. A lot of times we're just like, it doesn't matter, come on down, it's cool. So that's everything you need to know about what's happening with MCAT. If you want to find out more information about Wake Up Missoula, you can log on to my website, wakeupmissoula.wixsite.com/wakeupmissoula. You can find out all the links to your YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter needs at Wake Up Missoula. You can also go find MCAT.org on Facebook and on Twitter through my wakeupmissoula.wixsite.com/wakeupmissoula. So nice to remade your write it all out twice. It's a great tool for anybody to use to watch past episodes, past little segments that I do on the show, like stop animation, and past interviews as well. But I usually post all those on all my other links, including YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. If you guys are interested in taking part of any of our programming opportunities, we also are you can request an event recording through a Missoula Community Access Television. We go on and shoot your event. Just last night, we recorded a fundraiser for Rob Quist. We are unbiased. We usually prefer that a nonprofit organization or civic group asks for a taping. So what we usually do is we go down there and tape your guys' lecture, community event, fundraiser, rally, or anything like that to help the community through visual medium. So if you guys are interested, you go to our website, you go to the How Do I link right here, and you can go to Request Event Recording, and you submit our Media Assistant Grants form. And yeah, it gives you all the steps you need to do to submit a program request, and then you come up with programs such as these that are going to be airing on MCAT Channel 189 and on our Video On Demand at MCAT.org. You can watch these anytime, but they're going to be on. These are the newest programs for the next couple days, and they'll have some new programs that you guys can watch over the weekend on Friday. So without further ado, here is a bunch of new programs, and I do want to highlight Ryan Feddersen, who gave an art talk at the Missoula Art Museum, which will be played at the end of these May clips.
Everything is pretty much dollar. Understanding that, just because something happens doesn't mean that it's likely, and like unlikely things happen all the time, allows me to I think see the world in a much more accurate way. And so I almost want to go back and reread the Wikipedia article on Gaussian curves every week so that I can stop being like, this is weird, there must be something happening, but it's in fact no, sometimes you meet somebody who has the same name as you, and sometimes two people in the same neighborhood get the same kind of cancer, and it doesn't mean that they all have, it doesn't mean that there's weird, electrons flowing out of the wires.
So the world economy is unbelievably interconnected. And I gotta say, in the last political season, when all this talking about, free trade is so terrible, blah, blah, we have had trade basically forever. American Indians traded. It's what we do. We are going to exchange. But remember, we have one planet, so we have to figure out how do we trade in a way that is actually fair, because all of us depend on this. And unfortunately, this was my neighbor in Guatemala. This is Juan, he lived next door. And I, being a rich gringo there, I made $135 a month. I lived there in the 1970s. And man, I was like, that's the richest I have ever been. I mean, what is that? $1,500 a year, something like that? Imagine living here in Missoula on $1,500. Maybe you guys do. I hope not.
So you imagine if you're in an environment where you already feel unsafe on the basis of your sexual orientation or gender identity, you're being harassed, very likely to be verbally harassed, also likely to be physically harassed. And if you let officials know about it, nothing is likely to happen. This puts you in a really untenable place. And when you grow up with that legacy, it sets the stage for mental health disparities to occur. Also regarding bullying and victimization, policies forcing transgender youth to use a restroom that does not match their actual gender identity actually does place these risks at youth for further victimization and discrimination. So I know that people are following a lot of things going on in politics these days. I am not making a political speech. However, I would be remiss if I did not point out the fact that policies have an impact on the lives of people who live underneath those policies.
Dogs do what they do ultimately because it works for them. We all love the idea that our dog wants to please us, don't we? And they do want to please us, but here's why. Because when we're pleased, we're good news for dogs. When we're happy, we're playful, and we give them good stuff. And that's what they want, and so they do the things that make us do those things. So we're all training each other all the time, kinda. The dog-human relationship is mutually beneficial. So even if you may not be actively training or actively rewarding a behavior, just by virtue of being with you and being your buddy, you know, dogs get food, shelter, play, affection, spoiled rotten in the case of my dogs and most dogs in Missoula, Montana, from what I've seen. We are definitely a dog town here, and it's pretty awesome. As a matter of fact, I hope that this isn't too elementary for you guys, because I know that Missoula is a very dog savvy town, and I know that you guys probably have a lot of knowledge already. But I also see a lot of these sort of mythical ideas being promoted on the internet and on television, and I think it's important to kind of straighten that stuff out.
And so in the last panel we have the newscaster telling us that temperatures are continuing to rise, scientists are baffled by persistent global warming. So there's the question on climate change. And is it our doing? And here we're kind of looking at some of the behaviors Coyote exhibits that mirror our industrial and practices. And he gets to reflect our feelings of responsibility.
And that'll be the last time you'll see an art clip by Ryan Feddersen, because her art installation's gonna end. But let's move on. Let's talk about some city council. So the city of Missoula did a council meeting on Monday, like they do. It's every single Monday except for the fifth Monday and except on holidays. So let's talk about what some of the things the city were talking about today. Daniel Vasquez and Kyle Big Knight talk about Kiyoyo Powwow, which Kiyoyo means grizzly. So here is them talking about the powwow that's happening this weekend, Friday, Saturday.
Take this time to invite everybody to our event. Kiyoyo is actually one of the largest cultural events that happens in Missoula. We bring in approximately 4,000 people to the city of Missoula. Go ahead, I'll switch your spot. My name is Kayleen Bignife, and I'm kind of like media specialist, poster making extraordinaire. This is actually my work. So With hosting such an event as KIO, it takes a lot of funding, and most of our time is spent fundraising. And currently, we're looking for sponsorships for various dance categories. So this ranges from men's, women's, and also tiny tots. So we're looking for sponsorships for that. And so with that, we'd like to thank you for your time, and we again invite you, and we look forward to seeing you. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us. We are on Facebook, and we also have our own U of M website. So that, thanks.
All right, so you guys are invited to go to the Kiyoyo Powwow. It's going to be a great, it's always great, and a lot of the money that they raise goes to the dancers who perform their native dances, and they get to leave with a good amount of money and some hand-woven blankets that are made to honor them, and I think it's just a wonderful, wonderful event. I was at a powwow a couple weeks ago. It was a more of a kind of like an inner school MCPS cross the state kind of deal, but Kiyo Powwow is going to be one of the biggest powwows in, I don't know, in the Northwest for sure. So you guys can totally check it out Friday, Saturday. I'll tell you where you can find more information later on the show. Once again, we have some proclamations happening in this episode. I don't know, this is an episode in the city council meeting. So this is Marilyn Marler, and she's given a proclamation on Arbor Day.
And whereas Missoula has been a Tree City USA recipient for 29 years, and our city is blessed with beautifully treed mountainsides, tree-lined rivers, and canopy-covered yards, giving us pleasurable spaces for living, working, and playing. And whereas trees can reduce the erosion of our precious topsoil by wind and water, cut heating and cooling costs, moderate the temperature, clean the air, produce oxygen, and provide for habitat for wildlife. And whereas trees in our city increase property values, enhance the economic vitality of business areas, and beautify our community. And whereas trees, wherever they are planted, are a source of joy and spiritual renewal. Now, therefore, John Engen, Mayor of the City of Missoula and the State of Montana, hereby proclaims April 28th, 2017 as Arbor Day.
All right, so Chris Boza talked a little bit more about some of the trees and in and around the Missoula area, and he talks a little bit more about this proclamation.
This year we'll be holding Run for the Trees, which is our annual Arbor Day celebration. We'll be doing that on Saturday. We have a 5 and a 10K run. On Friday, the evening before, will be the official Arbor Day celebration. It'll be at the grand opening of the Missoula Art Park at the Missoula Art Museum. So folks are always welcome to come down for that. For those folks who are out and about, we will also have seedlings that will be given away at the Good Food Store between the hours of 10 and 1, and I will be there answering any questions that folks may have about seedlings and or trees. So.
All right. Once again, that was Chris Boza talking on behalf of the Arbor Day events that are happening here in Missoula. Once again, this Friday, they're having the Art Park grand opening. So the Art Park grand opening is going to be a wonderful thing. If you guys don't know, it's on the intersection of Patty and Pine Street. You guys can go there, enjoy some cool art park, and break in the new public porta potty that just got installed. It's based out of Portland, so it'll be pretty cool. We got another one. It's Pride Week, and here is another proclamation read by Marilyn Marler.
Whereas all LGBTQ+ Americans are deserving of the same dignity, respect, justice, and rights afforded to all citizens, a principle bolstered in 2015 with the landmark decision of the Supreme Court guaranteeing marriage equality across all 50 states. And whereas Pride Week is a celebration of the strides made by LGBTQ+ individuals all over the nation and a recognition that LGBTQ+ rights are human rights. And whereas the first celebration of LGBTQ+ Pride was a riot against oppressive forces, and we as a community must continue the long tradition of affirming those rights, dismantling oppression, and working to ensure that all citizens will be judged by the content of their character and that all people have a right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And whereas the University of Montana's Pride Week does not take place during June, when most Pride events occur, but centers around the Day of Silence, a student-led national event, now therefore John Engen, Mayor of the City of Missoula in the State of Montana, hereby recognizes the week of April 17 through 21, 2017 as Pride Week.
All right, so that was that proclamation. And up next, we got another proclamation, which is going to be highlighted as Religious Freedom Week, which wraps up the last of the proclamations. And I also have another quote right after it.
This is to celebrate Religious Freedom Week. Whereas there is an alarming escalation of national and local incidents and rhetoric directed against immigrants, refugees, and people of faith, and whereas we are Americans who value freedom of religion and want to create a positive environment where we can learn from each other's faiths, and whereas Missoula has a long history of embracing diversity and dignity for all people by statute and practice, and whereas we believe that open dialogue that doesn't demonize any side is critical to address the fears and concerns that exist, and whereas we want our community to be a place where all people feel welcome and appreciated, now therefore, John Engen, Mayor of the City of Missoula, hereby recognizes the week of April 24th through the 30th as Celebrate Religious Freedom Week.
All right, so up next we got a representative from Har Shalom Jewish Temple. This is Lori Franklin. She gives a few quotes for this proclamation, and she talks a little bit more about some of the events that they'll be hosting at her religious temple.
Really glad to receive this and share the honor of receiving a mayoral proclamation with both Arbor Day and Pride Week. I just want to say a couple of words, and I'm here with Eamon Ormseth, who has been the convener of a little organization called Salam that we constituted in December of 2015. When we were very concerned about rise in religious intolerance, specifically directed towards people of the Islamic faith. And we're inspired to work together as an interfaith movement in Missoula, the three Abrahamic faiths, Judaism, Islam, and Christianity, and also with those of the non-Islamic background. We also have fellow cooperators who are from Buddhist religion, Buddhist practice, as well as Hindu background, and others. So it's our base is broad, and our goal is to build relationships and to dispel misunderstandings and fears. And this is the eve of the last day of the Jewish holiday of Passover, which is a holiday that celebrates freedom. And so in line with that idea, we would like to celebrate freedom from misunderstanding and freedom from fear, and celebrate our Muslim neighbors and friends here in Missoula.
All right, so they also go on to talk about their organization and how they want to do interfaith collaborative with a couple of the other local faiths in the Missoula area. But that concludes your city council of the day. I'll have some more city council stuff. They'll be talking about some committee meetings today that will be airing on MCAT channel 190. Any of you can watch any of those by going on to ci.missoula.mt.us. This nice little website guides you everything that you need to know about what the city is doing, what the city is going to do, and what the city is going to be talking about, and how you can give your comment on some things that that need to be done, or some things that are being done that aren't kosher with you guys. So you guys can totally do that by logging on to ci.missoula.mt.us. I also am going to throw up a couple of their websites as well. Har Shalom, their website is har-shalom.org. The powwow, if you want to find out their link, it's umt.edu. Kieo, which means grizzly. And also ci.missoula.mt.us. And it's a great website where you guys can find out more information. But without further ado, I kept you waiting, and now it's time for the premiere of my latest stop animation movie. And when I come back, I'll talk about events.
Darn it. I'll lose them around here. I'm in hot pursuit. I need backup. Stat! Get back here, foo! You are under arrest! I'll show you. Whoa! Here's the razzle. Do you realize who I am? You can't do this to me. We own the police. Now while I'm still breathing, that won't be long. As long as there's good, honest cops like me, you will not win. You gotta be kidding me. I'm gonna honestly bash your skull in. You want that? You have to get through me first.
Well, at least I don't have to go through him.
You're still trash, you know that?
Stop!
You son of a...
Thanks, brother.
Not a problem.
Alright, let's line him up and interrogate him. I saw your face. Well, get used to seeing the inside of a jail cell.
The one with the biggest mouth has the most to say, so start talking.
Hey, I got nothing to lose, but you have everything to lose.
Man, finally I got some peace and quiet.
What?
What the? Get out of here!
We got you!
No!
Come on, you goot. Let's hold him down. You're not gonna get away that easily.
What are you waiting for? Go!
Done it!
Just a plastic stick.
How could this be happening?
Officer! Can you help me? I saw these robots!
There's nothing more to do. I don't think there's anything we can do.
All right, guys, let's talk about some of the events that are happening in and around Missoula. So let's kick it off with Hellgate Speech and Debate Benefit Book Sale at 10 a.m. this morning. Join the Green Ribbon Book Friday and Saturday, April 14th and 15th, for a book sale to benefit Hellgate Speech and Debate Team. They've qualified for national tournament in Alabama, and they need funds to help travel expenses. Proceeds go directly to the team. Please come and see them, grab some books, and support these awesome students. They got the... you got stories by Haji Hazan. So this is at the University of Montana this afternoon at 2 p.m. It's a Central Southwest Asia Studies Conference at the University of Montana. It's from 2 to 4 p.m. You got three storytellers, followed by a 30-minute Q&A. In a world full of virtually shared, segmented stories, we can easily miss the deeper truth. They invite you to set aside time to... for these stories that will help shape your lives. Hear the stories of refugee living under the Taliban rule, the story of human rights, conflict and suffering, redemption and courage, friendship and faith. Faiji and Fatima will graciously share their powerful stories with Montana, bringing a deeper perspective on the American dream as human rights. Shahid Haki Hashirath will also share his story. And I totally butchered his name, so I apologize. You got the Missoula Market Watch at the Public House. Do you want to own, lease, or invest in a commercial real estate in Missoula? So be at the Missoula Market Watch 2017, this first event of its kind in Missoula. Enjoy an hour of business networking with light appetizers, followed by 2 hours of dynamic presentation that will give you insights you need to succeed in Missoula's lucrative commercial real estate market. LunaFest is at the Wilma Theater. The YWCA is hosting LunaFest, is a local event hosted by Guts Girls Using Their Strengths program. Guts partnerships with LunaFest, an exciting national film festival featuring short films by, for, and about women to highlight the capacity, strength, and beauty of women in film and young women in Missoula. This event will raise funds for their summer outdoor activities, trips, and smaller percentage to breast cancer awareness funds and research as well. LunaFest will be held on Wednesday, today, April 19th at the Wilma Theater at 6 p.m. Doors open for the silent auction at 6, but the show does start at 7 p.m. Tickets are $15 in advance and $18 for the day of show. So it's $18 right now, just so you know. You got the New to Medicare workshop at the University of Montana. So if you're new to Medicare, from 6 to 8 p.m. tonight, at the University of Montana, if you are approaching the age of 65 or eligible for Medicare due to a disability, learn how you can make the most of your Medicare options. In this interactive two-part class, you will learn about the important enrollment dates, saving money on your prescription drugs, and much more. The second session each month presides a hands-on computer workshop so you can learn about your personal Medicare claims, plans and coverage. The cost is $35 or two for $60, and you can register to at April 2017. Okay, here is – I'll just make it bigger for you guys as well. Let's do this to – so here is the website right here. So it's April 2017, newtomedicare.eventbrite.com. And I'm going to wrap up. Those are the highlighted events for your Wednesday night. Here are some of the Wednesday music events you guys can go to. Celebrating the Music of Fish. If you like fish and you like fish music, PH, that is, you guys can go to the Top Hat Lounge during their happy hour starting at 4:30 p.m. It's great. Imagination Brewing Company is doing a public jam. So it's like an open jam. Anybody's invited to play and jam music at 6 p.m. Bitter Jug Band is going to be at the Great Burn Brewing Company. You got Jazz Night at the Top Hat Lounge starting at 7 p.m. Country Dance Lessons with Kathy Clark at Sunrise Saloon. The Motet at the Top Hat Lounge is at 8:30. It's going to be funk music. Karaoke Contest is going to be at the Eagles Lodge in Missoula. Caractastic Karaoke is at the Badlander. And Rockin' Country Karaoke is going to be at the Sunrise Saloon. So tonight is all your nights for karaoke. You got Eagles Lodge. You got Sunrise Saloon. And you got the Badlander to go do all your singing needs. Or if you want to just kind of try it out, you know, like, you know, you need some liquid courage to do it. It's the places everybody goes to do karaoke. And then those theater kids come in and just blow everyone away. Moving on to the some of the International Wildlife Film Festival films that I'll be filming. Electric Amazon is going to be at 2:30 this afternoon. Basically, scientist Will Crapton ventures into the cryptic world of the electric Amazon to unravel secrets of community of electric fish and their highly sophisticated sixth sense. You got the super hummingbirds are at 3:00 this afternoon. They're talking about some hummingbirds using high-speed cameras. It's going to be great. You also got Namimba's Desert Kingdom. And it's talking about the death of a giant and wild sev. Namibia's extreme desert makes it difficult for life to exist, but even large animals such as elephants and giraffes live here with amazing diversity. You got Magical Moors is at 4:30, with only 1% of Middle Eastern wetlands still untouched. Magical Moors shows the beauty inside these environments and how protecting them is one great step towards a reduction of greenhouse gases. And there's a lot more you can find out by logging on to IWFF.org. But I'm going to cut off a little bit sooner than I should. And you guys can enjoy a brand new, this is a completely brand new art clip. This isn't a lot of the same old stuff. This is from the Clay Studio of Missoula featuring new artwork by, let me see, it's a Pot Sketch 2017 in the Clay Studio. also got a chance to talk with Shailene Venezuela. She is the director of the Clay Studio of Missoula. I've met basically everybody who's been to the Clay Studio and more, but except I've never actually been to the Clay Studio. And I heard that they expanded so they can have more artwork and displays for people to enjoy. So you guys are more than encouraged to go down to the Clay Studio, and maybe you'll see me someday. But... Okay, I'll stop. Okay, moving on. We got some more events happening for your Thursday. We'll kick it off with the used book sale from the AAUW. I completely forgot what that stood for, but it's going to be at Orchard Homes Country Life Club, and this is happening Thursday, April 20th through Sunday, April 23rd during their open hours. They're going to be doing a used book sale, and this is going to be great. You know, Sunday is the bag day, so by then they'll be basically putting books into mystery bags, and you buy the bag. So for more information how to donate a gently used book, you can call them at 543-5975 or 549-3538. You're probably not going to remember that, but if you replay this video on YouTube, you can watch it again. Again, the number is 543-5975, also 549-3538, or email amfm64@msn.com. Moving on. The University of Montana, Sustainaganza, is going to be at the University of Montana. Sustainaganza is UM's annual Earth Day celebration, a collaboration between UC Sin, ASUM Sustainability Center, and other individuals. All aspects of this event are free and open to the public. This year's tours the UM's key sustainability efforts will take place throughout the day. From 10 to 10:30 a.m., there's the gardens at the Native American Center, and you get to meet the NAC Fire Circle. The UC Gardens, you get to do that from 11 to 11:45, and you get to meet in the UC Atrium. 12 to 12:45, it's the Rec Center Sustainability Meet at the Rec Center. 1 to 1:45 p.m., Lomenson Center and Food Zoo meet at the Grizz Statue. Montana Native Botanical Gardens meet at the Greenhouse near the UC. It's at from 2 to 2:50 p.m. It's the it's on the I want to say it's the south side, southwest side of the UC. There's a nice little greenhouse right there. It's pretty cool. And then from 4 to 4:30 p.m., Society for Ecological Restoration Garden, and the meeting place is to be announced. okay. There's a lot going on, and you can find out more information by going to umt.edu/events. But also, this is missoulaevents.net, so they have a more description as well. Stevia. Growing it, cooking with it, Missoula County Extensions, they'll be doing a sold as Truvia. They'll talk about the pros and cons of using this alternative sweetener. Recipes include how to grow stevia. You'll go home with a stevia plant. It's $12 per person, and it's happening at 12 noon tomorrow. So you guys can check it out. It's at the Missoula County Extensions office, which I do believe it's near the... I gotta say, it's near the Missoula County jail. So the next one is Little Pirates Fencing Class. So come discover your inner pirate in this fencing class for ages 6 to 8. Fencing is a lifetime sport that both athletic and strategic, and is often referred to as physical chess. As a sport, fencing develops coordination, core strength, critical thinking, and discipline. During the 6-week class, students will learn the basics of fencing, work on coordination through a series of fun games and activities. Class meets Thursday from 3 to 4 p.m. for 6 weeks, and the cost is $60. And this is going to be at the Missoula Fencing Association, and this starts at 3:15 p.m. tomorrow afternoon. Gilkey Executive Lecture Series presents Trey Lund. The UM School of Business Administration is hosting a Spring 2017 Gilkey Executive Lecture Series on April 20th. This year's talk... featuring President and CEO of Lund Food Holding Incorporation. Trees Lund is entitled Growing and Developing a Multi-Generational Family Business. Community copyright workshop for creators is at Missoula City Council Chambers at 6 p.m. tomorrow night, Sarah J. Rhodes and other members of the Intellectual Property Law, IPL, section of the State Bar of Montana will give a short presentation on general copyright laws and the process of submitting a copyright application. Attorneys will then answer questions and assist anyone in completing copyright applications. Participants are responsible to pay the government filing fees for electronics, $35 or $55, or paper is $85. See copyright.gov, docs, fees, HTML for more information on filing fees. So the idea is you go to copyright.gov and it can kind of guide you where you guys need to know about filing copyright. But this workshop will help people figure out how to centralize copyright, because a lot of times it's not good enough to say, oh, this is copywritten. It's like, yes, that works only so well, but legality, if you don't get an application for copyright, then people have the right to take your intellectual property, regardless of how YouTube robot cares. That's some repent rage or whatever. Noises Off is going to be at the University of Montana. A glimpse at backstage life and the perils inherent of the production process. This uproarious and much lauded comedy is a love letter to theater that follows an attempt of an overly ambitious director to stage a bedroom farce with the deck stacked against him in the form of an enthusiastic but inept cast and crew. And this is called Noises Off, and it starts 7:30 p.m. Thursday night, but you'll have plenty of chances to check it out. University of Montana has a lot of great actors and a lot of great people coming out of the theater program, so you guys can totally check that out. You can find out more information by going on to the umt.edu/theaterandDance. Montana's Unprotected Wilderness with Bill Cunningham. Montana wilderness legend Bill Cunningham takes us on an audiovisual tour of Montana's Unprotected Wilderness. Author, photographer, wilderness outfitter, instructor, and wilderness advocate, he has covered all of Montana's wildlands by foot or paddle. That's going to be at the Public House tomorrow night at 7:30 p.m. You guys can check that out. You can find out more information by logging on to MissoulaEvents.net. And here are some of your music events for your Thursday night. Just kind of go over, you know, over it, through it. You got Jazz Night at the Plonk. You got Shook Twins at Top Hat Lounge. It's going to be folk music. Open Mic is going to be at the Broadway Inn. Rocking Karaoke by Aaron B. Rocks will be at the Dark Horse. Honeycomb is going to be at Monk's. It's going to be a DJ. Rooster Sauce is Residence Week number 3 will be at VFW Old Beck. It's going to be rock music playing at the VFW Thursday night. So you guys can check all that out, MissoulaEvents.net. It's a great little website that I always refer to when there's upcoming events or causes, and also sometimes when I'm looking for people to interview about their upcoming events. If you have an event that's upcoming and you have a lecture or you have something that's important that you have to say on my morning show, you can contact me at 542-6228, otherwise known as 542-MCAT. You can also email us, mcat@mcat.org. Ask for Scott. And for Wake Up Missoula. So once again, thank you for joining me this morning. You can enjoy any of this by logging on to wakeupmissoula.wixsite.com/wakeupmissoula. So nice to remain right across so you can see current and past episodes. I put a lot of video content and a lot of fun videos on my show that you guys can enjoy. But if you want even more information, you go to mcat.org to find out about our summer camps. Once again, I'm going to go to mcat.org. Win this bike. Totally. It's going to be great. And we're going to be hosting our party on May 5th. You're invited. Anybody's invited. Everybody is invited. And it's going to be from 5 to 8 p.m. You don't even have to be there the whole time. You can be there and be like, oh, this is cool, and then leave. Just say, hey, MCAT, you're A-okay. We just want people to come by, say hello, and say how MCAT has helped the community in your mind. So for Wake Up Missoula, I'm Scott Ramph, and I'll see you Friday to talk about everything you need to know about what's happening this weekend and all the crazy events, because there's a lot going on. Thank you for joining me. ¶¶